We are discussing a very important and technical subject of foreign currencies for exporters. When you will become an exporter, you will get order in Indian rupee or in foreign currencies. But in majority of the cases, you will get orders in dollars, pound, euro and yen. Moment you decide to do business in a currency other than rupee, you are going to attract a new and very important risk, which is called currency risk. Let me share with you the importance of this risk. If exchange rates will move in your favor, you will make extra profit from your export transaction. But if this exchange rates will move against you, you are going to have loss. It means these currencies can create extra profit or loss for you. It has become very, very important in these days to become a successful exporter to understand the intricacies of currencies. Now let us discuss this topic quite in detail.
Now friends, let us discuss this technical subject quite in detail. Why? Because if you will ignore the currencies and you have seen the volatility in exchange rate, a profitable export transaction will become a loss-making transaction, or if you are lucky, a loss-making transaction will become profitable transaction if exchange rate will move in your favor. And this is an area which need very serious attention of exporter, whether he is a small exporter, medium exporter, or big exporter. Most important thing is, we should know, what is this foreign currency? Why its exchange rate against a rupee change? And who makes the change? What is the system? Because understanding of this system is very, very essential for exporter. Friends, dollar rupee rate is very, very important for India and exporters, because 85% of our export and imports, we do invoicing in dollar. And dollar rupee rate is fixed by forex market, biggest market on earth. And daily turnover of this market is about $5 trillion in a single day. And this market never sleeps. Why I am taking a minute to explain to you? Because tomorrow you are doing export, you are earning dollars, but rupee, how much rupee you will get depends upon whether this forex market is taking the dollar up or down. If this market will take dollar up, you will get more rupees. And if this market will take dollar down, you will get less rupee. Mean your profitability will be affected by dollar rupee exchange rate, which is decided by not Indian government, not USA government, but it is decided by a forex market, which is a global in nature, which never sleeps, and it is controlled by speculators. That's why the exchange rate, they change very violently and directionless. Take the dollar rupee rate, about 2-3 months back, it was 65-66 rupees. It went to 74 rupees. Now it is 72 rupees. So if you are exporter doing business in foreign currencies, dollar, pound, euro, you must know that this forex market is taking your invoice currency up or a down. And problem is, this valuation will affect your profitability. And for every transaction, you have to go to your bank. For example, you are giving documents to the bank. How much rupee you will get will be decided by the bank rate. They will calculate the export rate for you. For example, dollar rupee rate is one pair, but it has about 14-15 various rate. For every transaction in India, dollar rupee rate will be different, and banks calculate the rate for export as well as import transaction. And for that, it's always better to have account with the branch of a bank which is authorized dealer in foreign exchange. They will get you comparatively better. The question is, how bank can improve the rate? Let me share with you. Forex market is on the counter market, 1-to-1. If you have dollar transaction and if you approach four different banks in India, four banks will give you different exchange rate, which depends upon the amount of transaction, which depends upon your past dealing, so many things, and bank will quote rates to exporter and importer. And friends, it is always better that as an exporter, especially when you have a high value transaction, to negotiate for a better rate. What is the better rate for exporter? Higher dollar rupee rate is better for exporter. Lower dollar rupee rate is better for import transaction. We have seen that dollar rupee rate decided by forex market, controlled by speculators, and purely it depends upon demand and supply of dollar against rupee. If demand of dollar is high, dollar will appreciate. If supply of dollar is high, it will depreciate. Friends, this will happen in the forex market, but whatever is happening in the forex market will have reflection on exporter, how much rupee he is getting now, because it depends upon exchange rate, and exchange rate depends upon demand and supply of a dollar against a rupee in the forex market. Friends, this creates special risk which is called currency risk. Export business has its own risk. But if you are doing export and drawing invoice in dollar, euro, yen, or in any foreign currency than rupee, you are creating another risk which is called currency risk. This risk depends upon amount of the foreign currency transaction you are doing. Higher the amount of transaction, higher will be the risk, plus the exchange rate change. Friends, I give you a very simple example to understand. You have done shipment and today dollar rupee rate is say 71 rupees a dollar. These goods will reach to the buyer, buyer will make payment, and these payments are from bank to bank. The day you are getting payment in India of your dollar export transaction, rate will be different. Not be 71 rupees, it could be 69 rupees. And if it happens 69 rupees, that exchange rate has changed during this period to 69 rupees, which is in the control of the forex market, you will get less rupee. Your profitability will be affected. But second situation is, during this period, dollar appreciates 74 rupees. So in this case, you are getting extra cash profit. Why? The exchange rate have moved in your favor, and it depends upon the amount of transaction. If amount of transaction is higher, more money you are getting. Transaction is small, you will get something, but amount will be less. So we should understand very clearly that if tomorrow I am doing export business and I am doing invoicing dollar, pound, euro and yen, I have invited a new risk which is called currency risk, which depends upon the movement of the exchange rate in the forex market, which are not under your control. That is very, very important to understand. And problem with this risk is, this exchange rate, if they are moving in your favor, they will create extra profit for you. And if this exchange rate moves against you, it will eat away your profits. And if exchange rate move against you, a profitable export transaction can be converted into loss-making transaction. Now, question is, can I do export invoicing in a rupee? Because if I do it, then there will not be any risk. Let me share with you, as per FEMA, it is allowed as an exporter, you can do invoicing in Indian rupee or in foreign currencies. When you are doing invoicing in rupee of your export transaction, your currency risk is nil, but it has not removed the currency risk. Now, risk will be borne by the foreign buyer. If you are doing invoice in dollar, you are taking the risk. If you are invoicing in rupee, your buyer is taking the risk. So friends, foreign currency invoicing create risk and has a potential to convert profit-making transaction a loss-making transaction and a loss-making transaction a profit-making transaction. Why I am repeating this? Because this risk is quite substantial. Understanding of this risk is very crucial to get success in export business, because export business is a long-term approach towards business, and you have to have the long-term stay in the business, and you have to be very particular about this risk if you want to become a successful exporter and want to do business for long time. Now, question comes, this risk is very substantial. How to protect as an exporter against this currency risk? And friends, let me share with you, rates will change. And there is no insurance company on earth which says that if you will have loss in currencies, because currencies have moved against you, take insurance from me, I'll protect you. No insurance company on earth can protect, give protection against currency risk. And then friend, how to protect? We have to do hedging. Hedging mean covering this currency risk particularly. You have to develop understanding and special approach to hedge currency risk. And for that, we have to do hedging. And I want to explain to you hedging in a very, very simple manner. If you have export transaction, then your rupee realization depends upon exchange rate. If exchange rate 72 rupees, 73 rupees, 74 rupees, when your payment in dollar comes, you are getting extra profit. But if today rate is 71.50 and when your payment comes, exchange rate move to 70 rupees, then you will have loss on your export transaction. So friends, if you don't do anything, if you don't do hedging, your export realization in a rupee depends upon dollar rupee rate. If they are moving in your favor, more money. If they are moving against you, you lose money. If you want to protect, what protection? That these exchange rate will change, but they should not disturb my profit margin, then you have to use derivatives. Your bank will help to select the right derivatives. Plus, government has introduced derivatives which are available on exchange house, and very shortly I am covering those derivatives for your knowledge and information. It means no insurance company, but I have to use derivatives from the bank or exchange house and develop a hedging portfolio. After that, exchange rate will change. Whether they are moving in my favor or against me, my rupee realization from export rate will remain the same. In this case, if transaction is for $1 lakh, I will get 71,50,000 because I have today hedged my export transaction at 71.50 and develop the hedging portfolio which I am sharing with you on the screen. Then, different type of derivatives are available for hedging currency risk. And basically, you can divide them into two parts. One is one type of derivatives which are available with bank only. Meaning you have to go to the bank to buy or sell derivative so that you can protect yourself against this currency risk. And they are forward contract, future contract, option contract, and swap derivatives. So friends, your bank will be the best consultant to help you, number one, whether you should hedge or not hedge. The banks provide free consultancy. If they feel that today you have done the shipment of your export transaction and you are receiving money, say after 10 days, 1 month, 2 months, and during that period, dollar rupee rate may be moving against you. If rate will be unfavorable in future, they will recommend hedging. If they feel rates will be moved in your favor, they will give you the advice, wait and watch. As long as dollar rupee rate is moving in the favor of the exporter, you wait, and the day they start moving against you, you can hedge with the help of derivatives. Very shortly, we are learning in which situation, as an exporter, I should use forward contract. In which situation, I should use future derivative contract. In which situation, option derivative contract will be better, and where swap have to be used. To use these derivatives, as I have told you, you have to go to the bank or you have to go currency exchange houses, because futures and options are available with the bank as well as on currency exchanges. The beauty of currency exchange is, number one, the amount of contract is very low, $1,000, £1,000, €1,000, 100,000 yen value of one contract. Mean even small exporter and importer can go to the exchange house and use the derivatives. But if you want, bank will also give you derivative hedging to hedge you against currency risk. The most important derivative, the forward contract. Cheap, best. Just pay 1,000 rupees to the bank, irrespective of the amount of export, 5,000 or 1 million, irrespective of the currency, dollar, euro, yen, pound, whatever it may be, you give the details about your export transaction amount, currency, and the period. Do you want to cover currency risk for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, up to 12 months? Forward contracts are very relevant, very cheap, and moment you pay 1,000 to them, they will give you forward rate for your today. For example, you have export payment coming after 1 month, and exchange rate will move against you. This is the explanation, this is the report given by the professionals that dollar will come down. So best is you go to the bank, pay 1,000 rupees, give them the detail of your export transaction. They will give you in writing the forward rate, which will be applicable when your payment will come after 1 month. On settlement date, whether dollar appreciates, depreciates, you will get the rupee equivalent at the forward rate, which was fixed by the bank, in this case, a 1 month earlier. So, forward contract is very cheap, best, and you bank will help you to develop with the help of forward contract. Future currency are available. As an exporter, you can open account with the future currency brokers, because bank don't give this facility. As an exporter, you have to sell future contract help of the broker. They will give you the rate. When your payment will come, export payment will come, you will get the rate from the bank at the current rate, but at the same time, you have to buy dollar in the future market and close the future transaction. And if rates move favorable, you will get more rupee equalization of your export transaction from the bank, but you will have loss in the future market. And if dollar will come down, you will get less rupee from the bank for your export transaction, but you will be compensated by the future market, and this compensation may be equal, may be more, may be less than what actually you are getting from the bank. Future contracts are good for small transactions, and basically this future currency market is more used by the speculator than exporters and importer. Now friends, options are also available with the bank as well as with the exchange houses. Two type of options are there. One is called put option, other is called call option. For exporter, put option is the best. Go to the bank or open account with the exchange house, NSE, BSE, through broker. You can buy option from the bank. Which option? Put option. And bank will give you the rate which will be applicable to your export transaction, and they will charge upfront premium from you, and they will give you the rate. When payment will come, and you can use this rate if it is a favorable, and you can say that I am not using this rate, because market rate is favorable to you. So option give you the choice to use the rate which bank is giving or not to use the rate. And option is comparatively giving you flexible hedging. If on the due date rate is favorable, use it. Rate is not favorable, don't use the option. Only option give you the right to use the rate, but no obligation. Friends, exporter must hedge with the help of forward, future or option. Protect the profit margin. Please don't try to make money from currencies. That is not your area. What is most important is, if you are making 10% margin on your export transaction, please protect that 10% by using derivatives. And very simple derivative is forwards. And I am summarizing it. If rates will move against you, forward contract. If rate can move in your favor and against you, then option derivative is comparatively better. And with this understanding, you will be able to manage your currency risk and protect your profit margin. We have already covered various aspects of currency risk management for export transaction. And we have seen that if an exporter ignore this area, this risk which is caused by fluctuation in exchange rate can convert their profit-making transaction into a loss-making transaction. And there is no insurance company available on earth which can protect exporter against currency risk. And we have seen to protect against this risk, you have to do hedging. And for hedging, you have to select the right forex derivatives which are available with the banks as well as in exchange houses. What these derivatives do for you, that they will give you a rate of your payment which will come in dollar in future. It means today you know how much rupee you will get from your export payment. And currencies are very, very essential. They must be maintained. And if exchange rates are moving against you, use forward contract. If exchange rate will move up or down directionless, then option derivatives are better. And your banks will help you to select the right derivative for hedging. Thank you.